Hello children, today we are going to understand angles. This is lesson number 15 of standard 6 foundation mathematics book. Before we understand what an angle is, we need to understand what a ray is. Take a point O and draw a line that moves indefinitely in one direction. So OA is the line that is moving indefinitely in one direction. We have shown it with the help of this arrow. This arrow shows that there is no end point of this line. It is moving indefinitely in this direction. But here we have marked it a point. This means that here is the end point. So this is the ray OA. We need to understand a ray. Why? Because angles are formed by two rays. Look at this figure. OA is the initial position of the ray. From OA, the ray started rotating. This was the initial position and it reached a final position OB. So now we have two rays, OA and OB. These two rays, they have originated from one point. So this point from where the two rays they have originated, this is the vertex. This is the initial position of the ray. This is the final position of the ray. Now the initial position is one ray. The final position is the another ray. These are known as the arms or sides of the angle. OA and OB are the two arms and O is the vertex. Now, when we see that there is a gap between these two rays, this is the measure that is formed between the rays. This measure formed between the two rays is the angle. OA, OB, two rays. There is a measure that is formed between these two rays. This is the angle. Now the amount of rotation, this amount of rotation, that is the magnitude or the measure of the angle. From here till here, the amount of rotation from the initial position to the final position is the magnitude or the measure of the angle. Magnitude is measured with the help of a protractor. Magnitude of an angle is measured with the help of protractor. You know what a protractor is and you know how to measure an angle because you already had this in standard 5. The more the opening of the arms, these are the two arms, the more will be the opening of the arms, the more is the magnitude of the angle. Look at these two figures. In this figure you see OB and OA are two rays, but the arms are close enough to each other. But here PQR is an angle formed by QR and QB and the arms are far apart. So when we have the opening of the arms less, then the magnitude of the angle is also less. When we have the opening of the arms more, then the magnitude of the angle is more. So angle AOB is less than angle PQR. We measure angle with the help of the protractor, and the standard unit of measuring an angle is degrees. The standard unit for measuring an angle is degrees and it is denoted by this sign. So 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Now we will learn first how to name an angle. Naming an angle. An angle is always named by the vertex or the vertex at the center, and it is denoted by this symbol. So this is AOB. Angle AOB. First, it is what we have written over here, that are always named by the vertex. So O is the vertex. We have named it as angle O. And or by vertex at the center. So vertex will be at the center. AOB, or we can name it as BOA, and we put the sign of angle before it. Angle AOB or angle BOA. If the arms are not named, only the angle is named as 1 or X or Y or Z, any alphabet or any number, then we name the angle by giving the angle sign and giving the name of the angle. Here 1 is given, so angle 1. Here X is given, so angle X. Now, what is interior and exterior of an angle? OB and OA are the two rays. Now, you see there are so many points over here. Few points, they are lying on the arms of the angle. Few points are inside the angle and few points are outside the angle. So, the region of the plane lying inside angle AOB is called interior of angle AOB. So, point CDE, these points lie in the interior of angle AOB. Region lying outside angle AOB, these are the points lying outside AOB. This is the exterior of angle AOB. So, points lying over here are said to be lying in the exterior of angle AOB, that is X, T, Y, Z. They are lying in the exterior of angle AOB. S, R, P, Q. These points, they are lying on the arms of the angle and is called the boundary of angle AOB. The part of the plane consisting of all the points that lie on the arms of the angle is called the boundary of angle AOB. So, S, R, P, Q are the points that lie on the boundary. In the next video, we'll be learning about the various types of angles. Thank you and have a nice day.